Ragnvold, I wanted to throw a quick question your way. You know, a lot of the work we've done in the past has been with sports and weather, and I've always noticed that the data sets are massive just for any of these events. But at the end of the day, when you're looking at something like weather, you can only show a limited amount of data. There's only so much time because you have one stream. So you can show the highs and lows, maybe a 3, 5, or 7 day forecast precipitation. But that must be just a fraction of the data that you have available. What do you think the opportunities are now that with the data that you have to deliver these targeted experiences to end users and the audiences we're going after?
Yeah, I think that's a very good question. I think we see a shift now, moving from the general broadcast you have today, the linear TV, of course, where you can see a weather show going from A to B and you have to cover everything. Now we can do it in different ways and we can combine this. So we could have the general show, but we could in fact target regions or even cities or even the specific end user with what they are interested in and the data they are interested to see, the forecast they are interested to see, or the observations or whatever kind of weather data. But an other interesting feature here is the interactivity, which is also offered through Singular. I think that's unique because then you can engage the client, so the user, which is the client in this case, in a totally different way than we do today. You know, you can in fact ask the users questions as we go along in the weather show, and you can put it on air in real time very easily on any device. You can do it from your computer or a mobile phone or whatever. I think that's a very interesting feature, which will come, of course.
I think it's really exciting to see how this collaboration can really unlock the power of the massive amount of data that you have available for people to drive their own experiences. Someone might want to be looking at the weather just so they can go shopping today. And someone might want to look at annual averages and why they're planning a vacation in 6 months. And they can choose what experience, what information they want to see as it's going on. I think collaborations like this finally deliver on the promise of true interactive TV, something we've been promised for years, but hasn't really been available. And you think of something like weather data, which is quite fundamental. We've come just generally are used to accept seeing that. We see it out, look at it on our phones quickly. But in this type of format tied in with media, it makes that engagement of the content being viewed that much more and empowers your end users to really, really create the experience that they want to see. So I'm very excited to see how our partners and clients will be using this platform.
Yes, and this is also where the partnership and Singular platform elevates their offering from StormGeo, because obviously we have all these data covering all the world, the regions, cities, and so forth. It's satellites, radars, weather models, and so forth. And we have all these pieces, but we really didn't have any way to kind of gather them into one solution. And when we're looking in the marketplace, we try to find someone, okay, how are we going to do this? And one very interesting thing here is the standards you're using. You're using open standards to make Singular Live platform. So actually, you're also opening up for lots of people being able to work on it, use it, and publish the content like we do for the weather. And it also opens up for, you do not need all these specialists anymore, as you typically had in the older systems. It's the HTML5 overlays and so forth, the WebGL, all the new standard technologies. And in this way, we are able to glue it together in one solution. So you actually, when the anchor or the weather talent goes on air, or before they go on air, they can choose the city they want to show. They can select another area that they had yesterday, just operating it from the browser, and then the playlist is ready and they can go on air. It's very, very, very smooth.
That's a great point, Ragnvold. And that really was designed because we recognize that the media landscape is going through quite a transition right now. A transition for traditional methodologies of content production to maybe next generation and digital or cloud-based productions, but we're still in that transition. I think a lot of our broadcast clients have invested in traditional workflows and now trying to understand and figure out how do they migrate to this next generation. And the great part about this collaboration is the data is available. Singular for today can allow them to do their SDI workflows with integrated data. Then if they wanted to do alternate feeds for regional broadcasts, they can put it into the cloud, multiplex it, and do 5 or 10 or 20 unlimited amount of feeds. And ultimately, when they're ready to go client side and do true interactive on end devices or smart TVs, it's the exact same overlay, the exact same technology, nothing changes. And as this technology evolves, we'll make sure that the Singular platform works on as many devices as possible. But right now, pretty much any web-enabled device can support a Singular overlay, really opening it up to a much larger audience than these dedicated bespoke systems of the past.